The worm saga continues with another molluscan mystery, and this one looks even more like a worm than the squid-like Nectocharis. Allow me to remind you that worm is not a real taxonomic category in biology. Rather, it describes any animal with an elongated, simplified body form. So yes, there are earthworms, which are related to leeches, and polychaetes, and giant tube worms, which, by the way, can be as long as Jeff Goldblum is tall. But there are also flatworms, and ribbon worms, and nematodes, and velvet worms, which do have legs, but are still considered worms, illustrating just how unserious this category is. There are so many types of worms across the animal kingdom that it surprises me how much people joke about carcinization, where things turn into crabs, versus vermification, where things turn into worms, because every single phylum has some kind of worm in it. It seems the end evolutionary result is worm. Anyway, all things considered, you don't need to be very creative to call a mollusk a worm, which is great news in this case as we investigate Odontogriphus, the Toothed Riddle. Simon Conway Morris began working with this single fossil specimen in 1976, over 50 years since its initial discovery during Charles Walcott's expedition. It was 6 centimeters long, oval-shaped, and showed no evidence of appendages or segmentation, so he concluded that it must be gelatinous. The most interesting part of this creature is its mouth, located on its underside. It appeared to possess at least 25 conical teeth, each 0.5 millimeter in length. Conway Morris concluded that these teeth may serve as a base for feeding tentacles of some kind, but this type of structure did not align with any known animals. He then took this a step further and concluded that perhaps this specimen solved the age-old mystery of conodonts, which are teeth commonly found fossilized from before the Triassic period. Because soft tissue does not fossilize as easily as hard tissue, these teeth were all that remain of an unknown soft-bodied organism. Conodonts did not quite match the teeth found on Odontogriphus and proved a better match to a few fish-like fossils described later on. So, how do we explain Odontogriphus? More specimens have been uncovered since the 70s, and the puzzle has been revisited a few times since Conway Morris moved on from it. John Foster's book, Cambrian Ocean World, published in 2014, states that Odontogriphus resembles a Cambrian shoe insert. Foster explains that Odontogriphus was likely a primitive mollusk. Its teethy mouth could have been the beginnings of a radula, used to scrape algae from the ocean floor, as it has been found in close proximity to cyanobacteria. Specimens also reveal details about its innards, most importantly, the intestines, stomach, and anus. It also may have had a thicker area of flesh along its underside, similar to the foot of a snail or chitin. If you're wondering how Conway Morris completely missed the molluscan assessment of Odontogriphus, keep in mind that he was fresh out of grad school, working alone, and choosing the most bizarre specimens he possibly could. In Gould's words, Simon's decision to publish on the rarest and oddest specimens and to range widely in his interpretations almost guaranteed some significant mistakes. The natural sciences continue to materialize as the art of proving each other wrong. Without people willing to make ridiculous guesses and take leaps of faith, science would not progress. That original specimen of Odontogriphus would remain in a drawer, too daunting, as would most of Walcott's collection. Instead, I get to read Gould's nostalgic tales of drama and share my knowledge with anyone on earth willing to listen. How wonderful a life to share a common interest with complete strangers, forging a distant connection between each other and to the creatures that predate us by 500 million years. Thank you so much for watching. I recently reached 100 subscribers, so I feel pretty good about that. Thank you so much. Please check out my other videos if you haven't already. I hope to crank out some more content soon. I have a few ideas that deviate a little bit from what I've been doing so far, but let me know if there's something you want to see from me. If there's a specific Cambrian animal you want to see here, I'll probably get to it eventually, but feel free to let me know and I'll make sure not to overlook it. Thanks again. Bye!